My name is Ebo Matthews. I'm a staff scientist, group leader, PI of several projects here at Lawrence Livermore.
I'm the group leader of biochemical and biophysical systems. That sits in the biosciences and biotechnology division within physical and life sciences.
I'm the division leader for the nuclear and chemical sciences division in PLS.
I'm the chief scientist of the energy program. It means that I'm in charge of the director's carbon initiative.
I'm Jennifer Petridge, and I am a group leader in the Environmental Isotope Systems Group. I did a master's degree on the East Coast at the Yale School of Forestry, and then actually worked for a couple years and decided that I wanted to be my own boss. And so I came out west and did a PhD at UC Berkeley.
When I finished grad school, I came to the United States on a Lavoisier fellowship, and I did a postdoc at UC San Diego.
I came here straight out of graduate school. First and only job I've ever had.
I graduated from UC Santa Barbara in 1998 with a PhD in chemistry, and I answered an ad in Science Magazine for a postdoc position here, and I got it.
Right out of grad school, I started at a place called Bell Laboratories in Murray Hill, New Jersey, and I started in their photonics research laboratory. So I started here in 2006. I was at Bell Labs from 98 to 2006. And in 2006, I started right in with the optical damage sciences group here.
The choice at the time was to go to industry and go to a pharmaceutical company or work here at the laboratory. And I chose here for a number of reasons.
The fun thing is always to be flexible and to be ready to take another step and to be ready to fit into what needs to be done while also helping design what needs to be done.
The AD at the time said, we're never gonna make drugs here. Well, my entire group is working on some form of drug development today.
Many people at the laboratory come to me and say, you know, what's the laboratory want me to do? And I say, you've got that all wrong. That's not how Livermore works. If you're bright and attentive and energetic, you tell the laboratory what you want to do and you help guide your future.
Because when I came here, I was one of the relatively few people doing environmental science, it was just obvious that if I wanted to make a career here, I needed to make it. Somebody else wasn't going to make it for me.
That's the key about the lab, is that if you want to develop something within still the mission space, which is very large, you have that opportunity to do so. You can be really creative, you have to be persistent, you have to convince your sponsors that it's the cool thing to do, but it can be done.
There's always something new, always as in, you know, every couple years there seems to be kind of a new little thing growing out of somewhere that some part of my group or my background can apply to.
It's always dynamic. Things change, there's new challenges, you know, that you have to resolve. The funding flow changes and you have to adapt. And so you're in constant motion. You never know. I arrive, I drive in the morning, I always tell that to my team, and I have this plan for the day. And nothing I had planned happened. It's a completely different thing. And I find this keeps you fresh and engaged and happy to drive in the morning.
It's really pleasantly surprising and heartwarming to know how many people out there in the world recognize the work we're doing. And I guess it's because I still have that old thought in my head that, oh, Lawrence Livermore is, you know, known for its weapons research or, you know, some other discipline than mine, but you know, when I go to conferences, people know who we are.
One of the things that's really fun about Livermore is that we pursue the nationally important problems. And roughly every decade here, I've changed direction pretty significantly. And I think that's fun because I get to work on the things that are really important.
It's been important to me to do something that's a service. Working at a national lab, working for the government, it's the ultimate, right? It's the ultimate application of science for national good, right? And that's important. And I didn't realize how important that was to me when I first got here. I kind of separated those two. You know, I have family in the military, and you know, I kind of think that's the ultimate way. You know, you put on a uniform and you go, and that's completely legitimate, and that is a great way. But I hadn't really acknowledged or appreciated how much of a contribution this lab makes and how much I can make to its mission that's important for our national security, important for the nation.
I do believe in the mission of the lab. I think that helps anyone stay here. I believe I'm making an impact of some kind that's larger than just money or a commercial product or something like that. That's something that will be long lasting.